welcome to Noise Pollution. It's your buoy, Robert Vibrations. Got a new sound, got a new thing. Let's judge it. Judge it real good. I'll be the judge of that. I'm a human vibrator. Pretty much constantly scanning the environment for delicious vibrations with my face and my eyes and my ears, just enjoying life. Hoping for 4 out of 5 every time. It's almost 5 o'clock. There's something groovy going on though. With my little dog there, Connie. And it's getting better. Go to America on Sunday. Whoa, got a rager on there. Whoa, slightly out of focus. It's getting better every day. Yes. It's getting wetter every day. Fire and water. I'm in my element. Bang. Anyway, let's log on. Hope you're all right, yeah. It's been a minute since I've done one of these, but feeling good. Kegels. Something groovy and something's happening to me. And it's getting wetter, rolling stronger, warm and wiser. Wow, anyway, yeah, lovely. That's by the Kalman, the Gunter Kalman Choir. They also did this one. Oh, might recognise that one. I don't know, I haven't checked it. Maybe all this whole episode will get muted because it's some kind of copyright infringement. Anyway, yeah, I'm doing well. Listen to my rager crackling there. Wonderful. Yeah, this is the first February ever that I've managed to get into a detox. I've never managed it before. Yeah, it's been good. I'm 8 days in now to no exogenous neuromodulators. Yeah, life's good. As I say, I'm going to America, going to Austin, Texas, on Sunday to go and do Kill Tony. Looking forward to it. Oh, let me see if I can find out. Yes, I'm going to go to the comedy mothership, sign up for Kill Tony, see if I can get on stage. Here is the, look at this PA system they've got here. Let me see if I can. They've got the HDL. RCF HDL series in there, so I'm looking forward to putting my larynx through that system. Ooh, look at that, look at those subwoofers. Lovely, 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 lovely. Here is what Kill Tony's about. If no one's seen it, I'll give you a little 2 minute thing, Kill Tony.
And we've come to that time, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my God. How many of you have been fans of the show for a long time?
Oh, I have.
Well, then you guys probably know what's about to happen. Hall of Fame member.
The wonderful. My favorite. One of my favorite comedians at the moment.
The record holder for all-time appearances on the show and interviews.
And that's, having said that, I went to go and see Stuart Lee last night in the Phil.
On the show, I present to you the Tijuana Tarantula, the Rio Grande Rabble Rouser, the Carolina Caboose. The Memphis Strangler, the Vanilla Gorilla. This is the Big Red Machine, William Montgomery.
Really funny guy. He's got a penchant for Aphex Twin. And he's generally funny guy. So you have to write a minute of new comedy. You get picked out. I've got a 1 in 200 chance of getting picked out, but I've managed to get tickets. It sold out for months and months, but my friend Mike Martinez, who actually helped with the captioning machine, you may recall, he lives out in Austin, so we're staying there. We're going to have a nice time. We're actually out there for Valentine's Day. Obviously, he's his partner and stuff. We're going to have a nice powwow with them. But yeah, here's a bit of sounding good, isn't it?
fucking sold me pills a couple of nights ago. So
he's talking about one of the other people that were just on before.
I don't know what the fuck he's talking about.
People talking about how they sell drugs on a podcast, which is seen by millions of people.
Last week, an elderly couple in South Carolina was found dead in their home after the faulty heater in their house reached 1,000 degrees. Good thing they died because their utility bill was about to be fucking brutal.
He's great. I love him. And then I'm onwards to Bongo's Bingo USA. I'm going to go and help the guys get acclimatized on the 17th. We're going to come back via New York, and we're doing the Williams, what's it called, the Music Hall of Williamsburg. So that should be nice. It looks like a lovely venue. Looks like quite a tight. They've got a lovely L Acoustics line array there. Should be tasty. Quite a tight one. Yeah, looking forward to that. So a little break from. Yeah, maybe I'll launch. There's a very, very small chance I'll get on Kill Tony, but if I do, it will be hilarious. And hopefully, you know, if I do, yeah, great. Thanks, luck, the gods of comedy, for allowing me to do that. But if not, I'll get a chance to hang out in Austin. Get to come back via New York and see the bingo in. Maybe I'll win the bingo, and that'll be the story if I get to play. Anyway, let's come. Oh, just going to see behind the scenes here. So I was just going to show you my favourite. Sorry, this has all gone a bit weird. Yeah, let's talking about the bingo. Let me show you some footage from the last time I was in. It's great. There's my desk. Look at that VI6. Six, seven, lovely. So here's a strong dance off. Person. Nice. Some good moves here. Very elastic. Very elasticated person. Very cool. Very wonderful. Listen to my range of air. I think this next person was quite good. I think they ended up splitting the money. There we go. Nice. Bringy. End up splitting the money. And then John Johnson, very cool photographer guy, was there. Top capturing the event says Matt on lights. Got a micro scooter. You don't have a massive micro scooter, can you? The world's largest micro scooter. There's a one bit of one-handed action there from me. 1,000 people just having a laugh. I think I know why Jurgen Klopp's leaving Liverpool. Listen to this AI.
What Jurgen. A reception Liverpool manager Jurgen Klopp has received from the fans. He announced that he will leave at the end of the season. And Liverpool fans don't want him to go. They just love him. But every football lover loves Jurgen. Let's see what happens at the end of the season.
Cheesed off? I think people are singing his songs too much. And I think he's just staring down the barrel. He was staring down the barrel of so many years of just hearing how 40,000 people just love him every week. So that might be a bit intense. What I was going to show you, here's my favourite biohacker, Ben Greenfield. Here they are.
Yeah, definitely.
See what the golden poo chart is like. So show notes are going to be at bengreenfieldlife.com/laughs. But
do you reckon he likes elk, possibly?
I was over at my buddy's house.
He's on his podcast, but he's also on a treadmill, which is pretty cool. That's another biohacking technique. Unfortunately, forgotten the lady on the right's thing, but she is a poo expert.
And he showed me this black box. He's like, dude, this is the most powerful one-day cleanse ever. So I actually...
Dude, this cleanse.
Because I like the guinea pig, this stuff, I ordered it. And it comes with this guide on how to interpret the color and the length and the activity of your mucoid plaque, right?
So please refrain from Googling mucoid plaques. You know, it's pretty one of the grossest things I've ever seen, but, you know, he's pretty pleased as punch there, isn't he?
Things people mistake for parasites that wind up in the toilet bowl. And while I'm not going to put you on the spot to interpret mucoid...
Decaf coffee with some single cream.
Plaque. It did get me thinking, as I was reviewing it just this morning, over breakfast, over my green smoothie, looking at pictures of mucoid plaque, I thought I should ask Lauren if she looks at her poop, and if so, what she or somebody listening in could learn from that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, definitely. It's your daily...
Comment below if you look at your poo.
Work hard. And it's just like people are tracking their blood sugar nowadays, or their Oura Ring score, or whatever the monitors they're using. It is something that ideally and hopefully we're doing daily. Now, I have a lot of conversations. I'm like, how's your poo? Or tell me your habits. It's normal. Define normal, please, because everyone's level of normal is a bit different. But the ideal normal poo would be daily, if not twice a day, as well as a wealth.
You should be going number two times a day.
Formed, complete, SRC shaped.
She's pretty jazzed. She's pretty jazzed about the poo.
Like, there's multiple factors that can contribute to different types of poo, and mostly being our eating habits and stress levels. But that said, I do use this golden poo chart.
The golden poo chart. So maybe that's something you could Google. You could poogle.
Help people like really assess where they're at and get a better understanding of
poo
levels. But that said, I do use this golden poo chart to kind of help people like really assess where they're at.
So you can tell Ben here is he's kind of knows how funny this is.
And get a better understanding of poo.
Yeah, ribbons, pebbles, rocks. You know, I get the big dump.
Okay, so that's him. That's Ben Greenfield. And then one last thing before I go. I'm doing I've got loads and loads of these posters or posters from all the shows that I did in the Cars. Loads of them. I've got a signed Lee Scratch Perry one. It's backwards there, but Lee Scratch Perry signed Todd Barry one. I'm gonna do like an open house of all my gig posters when I get back. So if anyone's interested in that, if anyone has any gig posters they want to contribute. I was speaking to my mate Andy Hunt yesterday. We're going to do like check out gig posters, maybe just do a little gig in 100 Seal Street. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Again, I do have detox. Should have done that. I do have H2OCD. It's pretty intense. What can you do about it? Like I said earlier on, you can get involved with the Sweet Shed. Look at the stats on that. Lovely. So I'm selling them, £4 chilled. So if anyone's because if you haven't thought about water, you water. Thanks, Alanis, and I'll see you later. Bye.